Hello friends, now in a frequency response of MOSFETs we will be talking about high frequency response of common source amplifier. The common source amplifier is the most commonly used amplifier in MOSFETs, so it is important to study the high behavior of this amplifier at high frequencies. The procedure remains same. We will be replacing this MOSFET by its high frequency model, and then we will try to find out the transfer function of this amplifier, that is the ratio of output to the input. So for high frequency analysis of amplifier at high frequencies, the input coupling capacitor, output coupling capacitor and the source bypass capacitor are replaced by short circuit. So I will say replacing MOSFET by its high frequency equivalent circuit, high frequency model, and replacing what? Coupling capacitor at input, coupling capacitor at output, and source bypass capacitor by short circuit. The AC equivalent circuit becomes what? You can please see the AC equivalent circuit of the amplifier will be like this. Replace it by short circuit. Then we have the resistance RG. I have replaced this CCI by short circuit. This is the RSIG, is basically the source resistance. It's, I'm trying to distinguish this resistance. This is basically the resistance of this signal source. And this is the resistance connected in series with the source terminal. Fine. So here, then replacing this MOSFET by its high frequency model. So this is CGS, gate to source capacitance. Then we have here we have voltage dependent current source, that is GM into VGS. This voltage, this is gate terminal, this voltage is VGS from here to here. Fine. Then we have resistance of the MOSFET, that is output resistance you can say. Then we have drain resistance, that is connected in drain terminal. These resistance are not, it's sometimes called drain resistance as well, or output resistance of the MOSFET. And then we have the resistance of load RL, like this. So this is equivalent circuit. I'll redraw it again so that it's visible. So I have resistance R0. I have resistance, that is RD. Then I have resistance, that is RL. And this is output terminal of the amplifier. Fine. There is one more capacitance here between gate and drain. That capacitance is CGD. This is the high frequency equivalent circuit of this amplifier. So what I have done, I have replaced the coupling capacitor and bypass capacitor by short circuit and MOSFET by its high frequency model. Fine. So now here we have to draw it further. We will be changing it little bit again. First of all, for analysis purpose, I will be redrawing this circuit. We can see we have this. Three resistances are in parallel. That is the parallel combination of these three. So I can replace this equivalent circuit, these three branches by single branch, which is nothing but parallel combination of these three, and I will say that is RL dash. I am saying this is RL dash. And remember, what is RL dash here? RL dash is nothing but parallel combination of R0, RD and load resistance RL. Fine. Now, see on this side, I have the source of signal here. This is Vs, source of signal. If I see from the gate terminal on this side, I have two resistances. So I can replace this by its Thevenin equivalent. I can replace the circuit on this side, that circuit to the left of gate terminal by its Thevenin equivalent. We will see that this is nothing but I will replace by a single resistance R, I can say RSIG dash, and I will replace by a source, that is you can say minus plus ground Vs dash. Vs dash RSG is Thevenin equivalent of the circuit to the left of the gate terminal, where I will say where Vs dash is nothing but the voltage drop across RG, RG by RG plus R signal, that is resistance of source of signal, into Vs, that is Vs dash. I hope you understand the concept of Thevenin theorem. What do? You open this terminal, see the circuit from this side, voltage drop across this resistance, that is RG, is nothing but Thevenin equivalent voltage. For understanding, you can simply say VTS as well. But in textbook, I have used this to be Vs dash. So that is why I am saying Vs dash here. Otherwise, you could have used the simple symbol VTH. Similarly, R signal is what? Replace it by ground. See the resistance from this side. So that will be parallel combination of these two resistances. So R signal dash is nothing but parallel combination of R signal and RG. That's it. This is the equivalent of this R signal in parallel with RG. So I can redraw this circuit by this. That circuit has been redrawn. What is voltage here? VGS. What is voltage here? V naught. So I have to find the relationship between this voltage Vs and V naught. Let us see that. How to do? This is gate terminal. This is drain terminal. Fine. Now, what is V naught from output circuit? What do we find? V naught is equal to minus of this current is coming here, and this will go through RL dash upward. So this terminal, if current, this current goes upward, this becomes, this end becomes plus, this end becomes minus. Why? Because the terminal at which current enters into a resistance is positive terminal of the voltage drop, and the point where current leaves the resistance, that is negative terminal, fine, of voltage drop. So V naught is minus GM RL into VGS. This is what you have. Fine. This is RL dash. And you know what is RL dash? Parallel combination of R naught, RD and RL. Now, I have obtained the relationship between V naught and VGS. Now, I will try to find VGS in terms of Vs and V naught. What do we do? Applying KVL at node G. Now, remember one thing. When I am applying KVL at node G, I have to use this capacitance as impedance. Right? And when capacitor has to be used as an impedance, what do? You can either take frequency domain where its impedance is nothing but 1 by j omega CGS, or reactance, you can say reactance of capacitor. And I'm sorry, I did a mistake here. This is not resistance, this is capacitor. Please correct this. This is the capacitor, it is not resistance. Fine. So similarly, reactance of this will be 1 by j omega CGD. Either you can go for frequency domain or you can go for S domain. It is your choice. Fine. So I will be using S domain. So for S domain, the impedance of capacitor is S into this capacitance, S into this capacitance. So finally, we will be replacing this S by j omega. and it is not impedance, it is now admittance. S into capacitance, J omega into capacitance. J omega C is basically admittance, in inverse of the reactance. Fine. So now, when you apply KCL here, I will be using this capacitance, this as the capacitor, and it's basically, it is like this, VGS. Voltage at this node minus Vs dash divided by this resistance, that is RSIG dash, plus this voltage divided by this impedance, that is VGS. The reactance of capacitor in S domain is 1 by SGS. So for frequency domain, when you talk about reactance, it is 1 by SGS. And it is 1 by SCGD. It's inverse. Fine. Plus, then current in this branch. Current in this branch is what? This voltage divided by this impedance. This voltage minus this voltage by this. This is the current in this branch. This is outgoing current. This is outgoing current. This voltage minus this voltage divided by this is current in this branch. So VGS minus V naught divided by 1 by SCGD. I am assuming that you know the concepts of KCL in networks. When you apply KCL in the network, this voltage minus this voltage, this is 0. So this voltage divided by this impedance is current in this branch, which is outgoing, going away from the node. This voltage minus this voltage divided by this resistance is current going away from the node. This voltage minus this voltage divided by this impedance is current going away from the node. So this is outgoing, this is outgoing, this is outgoing. As per KVL, this algebraic sum of currents outgoing or incoming at a node is always 0. So all three currents are outgoing. So algebraic sum of all these currents is 0. Fine. So let us see it further. I can simplify like this. 1 by R signaling dash plus SGS plus CGD bracket VGS minus 1 by R dash signal, this is R dash signal VGS minus SCGD into V naught is equal to 0. And you know what is VGS? This is Vs dash. This is Vs dash, this voltage. Fine. And you know what is VGS? See from here. I can replace this VGS by this. So what do we get? 1 plus S CGS, CGS plus CGD, R signal dash divided by R signal dash multiplied by, you can pre-see this, I replace VGS by this, so that is V naught divided by GM RL dash. I'm replacing VGS from here. Minus sign outside. Then what do we get? Minus VS dash upon R signal dash minus SCGD into V naught, that is equal to 0. And from here, I can find the relationship between output voltage and the source voltage. Let us see it further. We are trying to find out the relationship between this output voltage and input voltage, right? So let us go ahead. VD now, what do we get? We get 1 plus SCGD plus CGS R signal, R dash signal minus S GD into R signal dash whole divided by R dash signal multiplied by V naught equal to and into, I'm sorry, it has to be into, I will GM multiplied by RL, right? GM into RL dash equal to VS dash upon R dash signal. And you can see this will be cancelling out. So this gives, and of course this is minus, this is minus, so there is minus sign outside. So this will, if it is minus sign outside, it will become plus, or you can take Vs on this side. So you get V naught multiplied by V naught here, whole multiplied by V naught. So V naught upon Vs dash is equal to what? 1 by, that is 1 by, because this is, and this is getting cancelled out. So there will be GM RL dash here. Why? Because when you take LCM here, so this will be multiplying to this, this will be multiplying to this. Fine. So you get GM RL dash divided by 1 plus, you can please see it carefully, you have what? S into R dash signal into C G S plus 1 plus GM RL dash, right, into what? C G D. This is what you have. I have just simplified it. What I have done, I have taken CGS here, S into CGS into this. So I have taken S CGS GM into RL dash here. So see, I have separated CGS and CGD. Fine. Let us go at. I'm trying to come at some conclusion now. For frequency domain, for and this if you see it carefully, please see it carefully. In case of high pass filter, high pass systems, the transfer function is A by 1 plus S into something. I will show you that. Fine. So here, this is the transfer function of this form, which represents basically the high pass, not high pass, rather that is a low pass, not high pass system, that becomes low pass system. We will see that gradually. For frequency domain, S is equal to j omega. Remember this, for frequency domain, replace S by j omega, that's simple. So what do we get? V naught by Vs dash is equal to GM RL dash by 1 plus j omega whole divided by omega h. Fine. But if you see Vs dash here, what is Vs dash? See it carefully. I can write it like this. V naught upon Vs equal to, this can be taken on this side. So that is Rg by Rg plus R signal multiplied by GM R naught in parallel with Rd in parallel with RL divided by 1 plus what? J omega by omega H. And remember, this is the transfer function of a low pass filter. Why? Because as you increase the frequency, this ratio goes on decreasing. So it will be something like this. If you remember the high frequency response, when you increase the frequency, the magnitude of the gain starts decreasing. High in case of high frequency. So for high frequencies, your amplifier behaves like a low pass filter. Remember, at high frequencies, amplifier behaves like low pass filter, and at low frequencies, amplifier behaves like high pass filter. Fine. So at high frequencies, my magnitude of this gain will be reducing because this omega is in denominator. So now, what is this omega H? The omega H here is nothing but the cutoff frequency. The frequency, this is midband gain, and this, there is a frequency called omega H. This is omega, this is gain V naught by Vs magnitude. So this, it's you are not starting from zero. It's like this as such for amplifier. So I'm talking about high frequency range. So at midband it is assumed to be constant, but at high frequencies it starts reducing like this. So at certain frequency called omega H, the gain becomes the value of midband gain divided by root 2. That is omega H. So omega H here is nothing but omega H is, you can see here, that is, you take it in denominator, so that is 1 by R signal dash into C GS plus 1 plus GM RL dash into CGD. That's it. Or you can say high frequency or high, this is higher cutoff frequency. The higher cutoff frequency of this amplifier will be 1 by 2 pi R signal dash into C equivalent. Where, what is C equivalent? C equivalent is CGS plus 1 plus GM into RL dash multiplied by CGD. That's it. This is the upper cutoff frequency of this amplifier. Or we can say at high frequencies, your amplifier is behaving like low pass filter. Fine. This is what I discussed here. So now, this factor, whatever I have written here after replacing this, this factor is called midband gain. That factor is called midband gain. Numerator of this. Why midband? Because when you put, make it 0, omega up to 0, you have this value, and that is considered to be midband gain. Because at low frequencies, its behavior is different. When I say omega equal to 0, as I say, it is not omega equal to 0. It is the frequency which is considered to be low frequency. Because at low frequencies, I cannot ignore the effect of this. So at low frequencies, the equivalent circuit I have used is not applicable. That is only applicable for high frequencies. I have obtained this transfer function by using this equivalent circuit, the equivalent circuit we have discussed. And that was applicable for high frequencies. So at frequencies, you cannot neglect the effect of these capacitors, and we have already seen the low frequency response of MOSFET amplifier. So here, this is the transfer function which is applicable for high frequencies. So that means at high frequencies, your common source amplifier behaves like a low pass filter, and the transfer function of that amplifier is this. The numerator of this function is called midband gain. Constant value is midband gain, this gain. And the frequency at which the magnitude of the transfer function reduces, midband gain divided by root 2. that is called 0.707 times the midband value is called cutoff frequency, which is given by this. So here interesting point is, because there is an objective type question, maybe in gate, maybe in engine services, based on this, this is the capacitance. Please see carefully, this is the capacitance which was appearing between gate and drain terminal, and drain terminal is output terminal, gate terminal is input terminal. So the capacitance which appeared between input and output terminal is what? Feedback capacitance. So that capacitance is appearing in the transfer function. So this is called Miller's capacitance. So Miller capacitance is nothing but 1 plus Gm into RL dash into CGD. This is called Miller's capacitance, and this factor is called Miller multiplication factor. Please do remember this, because in engineering services there was one direct question based on this. And what is the RL dash? I have already discussed that. RL dash is nothing but R naught in parallel with RD in parallel with load resistance. So this is the frequency, high frequency response of common source MOSFET based amplifier. Circuit is simple, but provided you know the concepts of network and the transfer function of low pass filter. I'm saying because I have discussed the low pass circuit earlier. This is the transfer function of a low pass filter. I have discussed earlier, at high frequencies your MOSFET, this common source amplifier is behaving like low pass filter. So this is the simple analysis. The purpose is to let you know how we go for mathematical analysis and how we reach at a conclusion that it is nothing but simple low pass circuit. You don't need to mug up everything, but those who are preparing for engineering services, they should remember this result if possible, because there can be one direct objective type question based on this. For the students who are preparing for GATE, that mathematical approach is important. That mathematical approach to come at result is important. Fine. So this is all about the high frequency response of common source MOSFET based amplifier. So in next video, I'll be taking the step response of amplifiers. So just wait for my next video to come. Thank you very much.